Welcome to early game Hatchets build for NIOH 2, you out of place bastards. Before we start with the build, I have to explain what early game means in NIOH so there is no confusion. It means first playthrough more or less, not first couple of regions or levels. In this case it is for first 150 levels or so. Max character level is 750 and there are 4 more difficulties beyond starting one, and endgame content on top of that called Abyss and Depths. New difficulties unlock one after another by completing set number of missions. Early game builds that I'm doing are for first playthrough for the most part, and they change a bit as you progress due to better equipment becoming available over time. You can play with same exact gear however for many playthroughs as long as equipment level corresponds your own. That is done by soul matching gear at the blacksmith or acquiring smithic techs that allow crafting gear at your level, which is much better option. Before levels 50 and 60 builds are not really possible, at least not very effective ones. Up until then, it is best to go for balanced stat distribution, with additional points into skill and any other stats required for matching armor set requirements. At around level 150, stats should look like this. Big difference is that skill has been dumped and magic has become main attribute. Reason behind this is that we have remodeled hatchets to scale off of magic, because it is far more useful attribute compared to skill. Rest of the points should be similar to mine, but you can lower stamina for a couple of points. Primary and secondary weapon are part of Onishibata set. Strong attack should be focus of special effects on hatchets. So things like strong attack key damage, strong attack damage, high stance damage are all good bonuses with all ablaze duration. Backstab damage is also not a bad thing. Onishibata set is great for this build because it focuses on high stance and gives us plenty of nice buffs like damage reduction and ki recovery. Good alternative is Kintaro because of focus on strong attack damage. Great thing about it is that we also get X as secondary weapon, meaning more buffs available. Rage buff damage wise is more powerful than all ablaze. With Kintaro you get more damage output but less defense. As for special effects on armor pieces, get things like elemental damage taken guarding on helmet, elemental damage taken on chest piece, attack on gloves, dodge key consumption reduction on bottom pieces. Another good bonus to get on chest and gauntlets is untouched Omnio. On accessories, most important ones are melee damage versus poisoned enemy and poison accumulation. On top of that, add anything you want, but untouched Omnia would be also a nice addition. Jutsu setup needs to look something like this. Try to also match the number of items from my setup, as I have found out these numbers work best. Element of stuff like Shikigamis and Elemental Stop Talismans depend on enemy we are facing, so they are constantly exchanged for different element type based on situation. Guardian Spirit is Atlas Bear because of damage increase buffs. Cores are Yatsu because of melee damage versus poisoned enemy. Humpty Dumpty from first DLC because of attack buff that stacks with other attack buffs when yokai ability has been used, and any Onibi core. If you want more defense instead of offense, go for Genbu instead of Atlas. For secondary Guardian Spirit, bring your Ho due to high attack damage increase. Again, if you want more defensive option, choose Inosasao. Starting Guardian Spirit should be Kagevani and the next one Usura Hicho before Atlas Bear. Skills we are focusing on are high stance ones, so get Piercing Hurls. Use the one you prefer, either Light or Shadow. Little Barrage is a great combo that can annihilate enemies, so definitely get that one as well. Demon Undercut is fantastic for destroying enemy ki. Right side upgrades are not bad as well, ending with Wild Surge too. On top of all that, all ablaze is a must. When it comes to Mystic Art, choose whichever one you want, both are fine. Good clan for this build is Takenaka. So how to play this build? We start off with typical stuff like Elemental Stop Talisman, Quick Change Scroll, Protection, Steel, Barrier and Purification if fighting against yokai. Against humans you can either use purification or only be yokai ability to apply element, your choice. Then comes all ablaze buff from hatchets. Now we cast weakness and sloth on the enemy, and prepare toxic trap or spam shurikens, whatever poison jutsu you prefer. Before attacking the boss with hatchets, spam couple of shikigamis to apply elemental debuff if possible. When it comes to hatchet attacks, I mostly use single strong attack from high stance and try to attack bosses in their backs. Good trick is to dodge and attack. It consumes a lot of ki, but that is fine. Upside is that strong attack animation after dodge is faster, and usually while rolling forward or a bit to the side of the enemy, you end up striking their backs with this method afterwards. When opportunity arises, that is when little barrage comes into play. It is great for applying purity or any other element you have on the weapon. When bosses start doing some OP shit and while trying to stay safe, you always have an option to use piercing hurl throw to do some good damage from range. Add Wild Surge Finisher for additional damage after piercing hurl, but be careful not to run into nasty boss attacks. Fantastic thing about this build is that we are really tanky and do awesome damage while at it. It is easy to play and very effective. Versus boss wave missions, Untouched Omnio is great stat to have through chest, gauntlets and accessories to save some of the spells for later fights. That would be all for this video, thank you for watching and enjoy!
が全身全霊いて参る。